Good morning, friends, and welcome to Munich, Germany, here at the 1972 Olympic Games shooting range for the first final of the day, 10-meter air rifle women. I'm Hillary Russell, and it's my pleasure to have USA's Olympic Games gold medalist in 3P, Jamie Byerly Gray, here with me today. Welcome, Jamie, and thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
You have had probably your life changed around a little bit since the Olympic Games, would you say?
Yes, just a little bit.
That was quite a win that you had. How does that affect you, you know, on a personal basis?
I don't know that it really affects me on a personal basis. I mean, it's something I've worked for many years, of course. And I mean, it's almost, you know, just a relief that it finally happened. And it's exciting by all means, but I don't know that it really changed who I am and what I'm here to do.
Well, I have to agree with you, but I do see that there's some people that have, you know, Olympic winners that their lives change completely, or I don't want to say it goes to their head, but a little bit, that they become famous overnight. But you seem like you've really kind of just stayed right in the groove, and you're the same Jamie that I knew, you know, from 5 years ago.
Yeah. I mean, I think that's definitely a good thing. I think it can go to your head by all means. I don't feel like I've really changed as a person by any means.
Now, you took the year off more or less because you were having some problems with your back. And
yes.
How are things going with that now?
It's better. Mm-hmm. Not the best, but it's better.
And I guess you do. You really do need to take a lot of time off for something, you know, in the positions that you all hold. I can't imagine. It makes my back hurt just watching you all, to be honest with you.
Some more than others. I train a lot of time into the position, into the standing position especially. I've never been a real strong standing shooter, so I have to put a lot more time into it. And it was an overuse injury that I haven't really tried to make better since 2010. And so after the games, it's really the only opportunity to take about a year off and try to rehab the injury.
Okay.
It was getting to the point where I couldn't train as much as I knew I had to, just from the sheer amount of pain I was in.
That must be really awful. I mean, you're young and everything. You were saying yesterday that you have a little bit of arthritis, and for such a young age, that must be really hard to hear.
Oh, yeah,
the doctors.
Definitely.
Yeah.
It's a lifelong, you know, something you're going to deal with for the rest of your life. It's manageable, of course, and that's what we're trying to do, is manage it as best as we possibly can.
Well, let's get back onto a lighter note here. back to the Olympics for a minute. Would you say it was down to that last shot that when you won the gold?
Or do absolutely. It always comes to the last shot.
For you, it always does. I mean, you come from behind all the time, you know, and people that in the past when you've been competing regularly, you know, my guest commentator will say, well, maybe, I don't know if Jamie's going to do it. I'll just say, you know, just wait a minute, because she always has a way of coming from behind and really nailing the last shot. And what did that feel like?
Yeah, it was amazing. It was, you know, in Beijing, I had the opposite happen. The last shot cost me a medal, and for the next 4 years after that, I've worked really hard at shooting the last shot. Some were good, some were bad.
Right.
And so it was great. I mean, I took the shot and it looked good. I knew it was a decent shot. I probably didn't know it was a 10.8, but I knew it was a good enough shot. So it's a great feeling.
And then when you heard that it was a 10.8, I mean, I saw your expression. You were just over the moon without
yes,
a doubt.
Definitely.
We're going to focus in now on our 8 finalists. I think there was about 10 women. These are basically the elite, the best of the best that have gathered here, have been invited here to Munich for the World Cup final. It's the most important competition of the 2013 series by any means. And so it's what we see in front of us is just high-class performers. And it's going to be a tough one today. You know, we've got three from the People's Republic of China, which is no surprise there. We have two girls from Serbia, and, you know, we've got Italy that's here, and two Germans. So let's just take a look here at firing point H in position H, representing Germany. We have Sylvia Raquel.
Yes, Sylvia is, I think, a little, you know, kind of new to this stage, and it's exciting to see her. And Germany actually brings some younger blood into the shooting world.
On firing point G, representing Germany as well, we have Sonja Feilschifter.
Well, she's obviously not new to this scene. She's probably, arguably, one of the best women's rifle shooters there ever has been. The only thing she hasn't done is win an Olympic medal. She's done everything else.
On firing point F, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Chang Jing.
I have not seen her.
That's right, you haven't been competing this year.
Yes.
She's, you know, her athlete's presentation, basically all of her awards are this year.
Yes.
On firing point E, representing Italy, we have Petra Zublesing.
Yeah, Petra we know very well from going to university in the United States, and we get to spend quite a lot of time with her. It's great to see her this past year just shooting so well in both events.
On firing point D, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Wu Liuxi.
And we've seen Wu around, and I mean, it's no surprise she's here shooting for a World Cup final medal here. So, of course, the Chinese are always
so strong. On firing point C, representing Serbia, we have Ivana Maksimovic.
It's awesome to see her just doing so well. She's such a nice lady, and I mean, just...
She really is. She
has great morals, and I mean, it's awesome to see her doing so well.
On firing point B, representing Serbia as well, we have Andreja Arsovic.
Yeah, I don't actually really know Andreja very well, but of course she's been coming up in the ranks, and I think her and Maksimovic are pushing each other a little bit in their country.
And on firing point A, after setting a new world record in qualifications, we have from the People's Republic of China, Yi Siling.
Not new to the stage, of course, our 2012 gold medalist in this event.
And yeah.
She's just been dominating this event for a couple years now.
She's really, really great. And we were talking before, she does have such a nice way about her. And when she wins, man, you've never seen anything like it.
Generally, she's excited.
She is, yeah.
Which sometimes is different for the Chinese.
Exactly.
Chinese.
They don't usually show their emotions at all. But
yes. It's awesome to see that.
So this is all a new thing for you, Jamie, because you haven't been competing that much this year. But just for the audience out there, just to let you know, the women start off and they have two series of three shots, which athletes have 150 seconds to shoot. And from there, we'll go into single shots. After the eighth shot, the first person, whoever has the lowest score, will be eliminated. And that will take place all the way up to the 18th shot, where we'll have our bronze medalists. And the 20th shot, we'll have our silver and gold medals. But we do have this preparation and sighting time. Let's talk about that a little bit. For people that aren't shooters that may be watching, what does that consist of?
Yeah, I mean, this short preparation and sighting time, I think it's 2 minutes. You know, you're just getting back into position, trying to, you know, get... They already had some preparation and sighting time, you know, 5 minutes, and this 2 minutes is just getting back into that, trying to feel the body, making sure you're back in the right position after taking the break for the presentation. Some people will shoot shots, some people won't. It just depends on, you know, what your preference is. The main goal, you know, your gun is obviously sighted in. The goal is to make sure you're in the right position.
That's right, okay. And once this is finished, then we're going to be going on to the final itself. It's a pretty fast-moving final now with the new rule changes. So we're going to find that this is going to move around really quite fast.
I think it's very fast for the shooters as well. So it's, you know, I mean, I shot a couple practice matches, and it was very fast for me. However, I'm quite a slow shooter, so I think it makes a difference. Your fast shooters probably don't really have a problem shooting three shots in 150 seconds, but for us slower shooters, it's definitely something we have to work on.
Someone like Sonia, who's in today's finals, she is known as being the slowest shooter out there. She's always the last one to shoot. So do you think this affects her, or do you think just a lot of training has gone in behind to see if she can keep up with that pace?
I would have to guess a lot of training goes behind it.
Okay.
Looking at her previous finals, you know, she was probably taking a shot in about 45 to 50 seconds after the start command. And, I mean, now you get 50 seconds.
Right.
You know, that 150 seconds is, on average, 50 seconds per shot. But you have to load in there as well for the three shots. And so I would say she's probably had to do a lot of work on just the shot process and trying to shorten that shot process up a little bit.
Because before, with the old format, it was 75 seconds a shot. Is that right?
Yeah. Yes.
And so that is, you know, that's considerably a lot. You know, 25 seconds less for each shot is a lot.
It's a lot of time, yes. Previously, you'd have time to take two holds if the first one didn't look quite good enough. Now, pretty much you're shooting the shot when you you have to shoot the shot on the first hold.
Okay.
There's no option to really take a second hold, especially if you're a little slower shooter.
And so we're getting this going now. Once again, there's two series of three shots that are going to start this off with 150 seconds for all three shots to be taking place.
Yeah, so it's definitely with eliminating a person in after eight shots, you don't have room to have a bad first couple series.
Right.
You definitely have to be shooting really good shots from the beginning.
And that's how Siling does it, starting off with a 10.9.
Yes, you can't get much better than that.
You really can't. And as you can see, perhaps on our score, well, you can't really see our scoreboard right now, but File Shifter, she was the last one once again to shoot. She started off with a 10.6. And we have Arsovic, who started off with a 9.7. And really, these two, the two first series of three shots, if you don't do well there, how hard is it to make up for that?
You can't make up in two shots. I mean, of course, someone else can maybe do worse than you, but after six shots, you know, it's you can make up a little bit of ground, but if you have two poor first series, it's very, very difficult to make up points in those next two shots before people start getting eliminated.
Okay.
It's also, you know, a different shooting when you're always on the bottom, almost getting eliminated every mm-hmm. time. It's a different mental, you know, you have to pull from a different mental game than if you're, you know, at the top and, you know, shooting well. If you're constantly being announced that you're in the top, you're in the bottom too.
Right. That adds pressure without a doubt.
Absolutely.
And that is something that's a little bit new. We do have an announcer here now, Jack Jay, and he is telling all the audience, obviously, but also the shooters get to hear exactly where they're standing. So, like, you're right, if you're in eighth position, you might be only down by 1/10 of a point, but you're hearing that you're in eighth position. That adds a little bit more weight to your shoulders.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you're constantly fighting to stay in the final.
That's right. I
mean, it's not before. You never had to fight to stay in the final. You were in the final until the end. So we do have some lower scores here in the bottom, so it'll be quite interesting.
That's true. We have Raquel, who has really done an amazing job, and you can hear that the German fans here are very pleased with this.
Yes, definitely. I think they're pulling for the Germans, maybe.
I think so, too. She's up by 3/10 of a point over Yi. Shang is in third place now, only 1/10 of a point. It's so incredibly close right now. If just to let the spectators know, after qualifications, their scores do not come over into the final. And so everyone has a chance of making it to the highest step of the podium.
Yes.
There's a bunch of controversy on that and about qualification scores coming over.
Yeah, and, of course.
But we're going to go into now the second series, and then we'll go into single shots. But Raquel, this is a surprise to me that she's now in the first position.
She had three very good shots, obviously, and it's quite good. I mean, very, very good shooting. I would take it any day of the week.
Now, Yi, you know, she started off with a 10.9. That must make you feel really confident. That must make you feel good.
Yeah, you know, sometimes it's, you know, you feel great about it, and then other times you're a little, it can be a little stressful sometimes when you're shooting that good, too, mm-hmm. as we just saw with Raquel shooting a 9.3 on the first shot on the next series. You know, it's you have to learn how to deal with shooting bad and shooting good.
Right.
It's two different kinds of pressure.
And it certainly doesn't help to hear the audience all go, oh, no.
Yes. You know, maybe as another shooter, it sometimes helps as the competitor.
10.4 followed by 10.1 for Chang.
Yeah, and Yi is definitely shooting well still.
She really is. She is an amazing, amazing shooter, obviously, winning the London Olympic gold medal. Maksimovic, 10.4 followed by 10.5.
Yeah, it will help her out a little bit. I think you know, the people we want to look at as far as eliminating, we have Petra Zublasing and Arsovic, who are kind of fighting it out down there.
That's right.
It's never a good position to be fighting for.
Absolutely not. And just coming off of a 10.8 here for Wu.
We can see how much it can change over just three shots. You know, Raquel has dropped down now to six.
Exactly.
So it it can change quite quickly.
One shot can do it, or a couple shots. There, the shooting in the nines.
Yeah, definitely.
Zubla Singh finishing off with a 9.4 on the second series. And of course, we're waiting here. We've got about 28 seconds left of this series, and File Shifter is the last one once again to shoot. And a 10.3 to finish off.
So we have three Chinese in the top three.
Yes, in fact, things have changed around quite a bit now. We've got Yi in first place by 0.4 over her teammate Wu, and Shang is in third place. Maksimovic is holding on to fourth place only by 0.1. But the people that we need to keep an eye on now are Zubla Singh, Arsovic, and Raquel. You know, Raquel is almost a whole point away from File Shifter.
Yeah, it's those bottom three are definitely close to two of them. Of course, will be eliminated. Is it two of them?
Actually, it's one of them. Yep,
one of them.
After the eighth shot.
Okay. One of them, and I think it could be any of them.
Exactly.
But Sonia is a point ahead almost, which is pretty safe from getting eliminated. But it's not necessarily about just being in the bottom. There's quite a gap between six and three.
Exactly.
So it's about trying to win the medal. And there's some work to be done.
There is some work to be done. But right now it looks like the podium is covered by the Chinese team. We'll see what happens in the next shots to find out what's going to be happening with that.
Yeah, and as we saw in the last series, anything can change quite quickly.
Yes.
A couple good shots can make a difference. And Petra has another 9, a 9.8. It's not going to help her out very much.
No, and a 10.7 for Yi. And just to let you know, for these single shots, there are 50 seconds.
Yes, this is also quite fast.
And the crowd is loving that 10.7
yes.
for File Shifter.
And she gained some ground
there.
She did.
She's put herself up into third place now.
Yeah.
Zubla Singh is still holding on to eighth place. She's almost a point behind Arsovic. What do you think about that? Any chance of coming up from behind? Or?
Yeah, I hate to say it, but she's probably not going to make it through the whole final.
There you go. That's a nice positive way of putting it, though, you know?
You know, she can possibly not get eliminated in this next shot because you don't know what Arsovic is going to do. But she's quite a ways back from the top of the pack, which is very difficult to.
Well, she's got a heavy load on her schedule, too. You know, Petra, she studies. She, you know, she trains often. And she also, you know, she had been studying in the United States, so she's going also with another language.
Yes, she was. I think she is back in Italy now.
Yeah, I believe so.
But I know she, I'm pretty sure her and Nico have moved into a new house. And life is definitely a little different. And she's shooting both guns quite well, so she'll be shooting the 3x20 event also. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of work.
Yeah, it is. It's a lot on her plate, without a doubt. Finishing off with a 10.7 for Zubla Singh. Arsovic finishing off with a 10.8.
Yeah, so we will
wow,
see.
Wow, things have changed around. Unfortunately, we are going to have to say goodbye to Petra Zubla Singh from Italy. She finished off with a point behind Arsovic. We have got Yi now. She's making her move, without a doubt.
Yes.
She's 1.3 in the lead. Maksimovic has now bounced up the scoreboard. She's holding on to second place by 0.3. And just on her heels, we've got File Shifter. So things have changed around here as far as the standings go. We've got two more shots to find out who's going to be the next one out. And at this point, we're going to have to keep our eye on Arsovic. She's 0.8 now behind Chang from the People's Republic of China.
Yeah, and as we can see, Sonia moved her way up the leaderboard quite easily, and same with Maksimovic. So I think, you know, you never know what's going to happen.
No, you really don't.
But I think the eight shots is definitely quick to eliminate someone. It doesn't give you much time to. Mm-hmm. You have to be on your game from the beginning.
Absolutely.
For sure. There's lots of good shots on this series.
There sure are. Everybody's in the tens. Very nice.
So it's hard to make up points when everyone is
shooting really well.
Shot.
Exactly. So we still have Yi in first place. She's made a little bit of a getaway there with 1.4 tenths of a point in the lead over Maksimovic. Wu is in third place, 3 tenths of a point behind. Only 2 tenths of a point behind her is File Shifter. And Arsevich, she is now 6 tenths of a point behind Raquel. I would have to say that anything could happen here.
Yeah, definitely. It's very, very close down there at the bottom. I think Yi is really running away with
it. She is.
This she is a 95.3. She's over 105 pace, and that's phenomenal shooting. So, as was her match, she set a new world record today as well.
That's right. And these are the two women that I think we're going to have to keep our eyes on for the future as well.
Yes, and I think we just saw a flip here. I think we'll have to. I think Raquel will.
I'm going to have to take a look at the scoreboard in just a minute here. Yeah, I'm not either. Mathematics is not coming to my mind right now. Let's see here.
I'm not going to try to do the math in my head. Just in case I mess it up.
That's right. Just waiting now on File Shifter.
Yes.
9.9, she's not going to be happy with that.
No, of course not.
Nope. And that is true. It was a last-minute change there. We have Raquel, who's going to be eliminated now in seventh place. Sylvia Raquel from Germany, finishing off in seventh place. Really, we need to keep an eye on this girl, though, for the future. She is going
definitely.
To definitely be making her mark, without a doubt. And just making it into a World Cup final itself is huge.
Yeah, and we saw how things can change. Her first series was... of three was very strong, and then it gets a little difficult.
Well, once again, Arsevich is in the hot seat right now. She's a point behind File Shifter. File Shifter has moved down the scoreboard with the last shot that she had. We still have Yi in first place, Maksimovic in second. She's behind 1.2 tenths of a point, and right on her heels we have Wu, only 3 tenths of a point behind.
Yeah, and I think... still, anything can happen. I think, Arsevich is a point back.
That's kind of...
quite a ways.
Yeah. Especially when you're going up against...
She's at 10.2, and so we'll have to watch what Sonia shoots here to see who will be the next one. And lots of good shots again on this series.
Absolutely.
And it's enough.
That's plenty.
Sonia has enough.
You know, you watch her face, and she looks even disappointed with a 10.8. She shakes her head like, oh, how could that have happened? I mean, a 10.8 is really, really great.
Yeah, I don't know if she ever looks exactly very
thrilled.
Happy.
Yeah.
During the final, at least. But that's the serious face. You see a lot of athletes like this.
So Yi has lost her advantage just by a little bit. She's still almost a point ahead of Maksimovic. She's 9 tenths of a point, in fact, ahead of Maksimovic. Wu is still holding on to third place. And this is going to take the next shot is going to be the deciding factor for Arsevich.
Yeah, it's
going
to be quite difficult.
That's really, really hard.
With a 1.6 disadvantage, and something drastic would have to happen for her to...
Somebody would have to shoot at the floor, I think, basically.
Well, we've seen
we've seen worse
some
than that
crazy
sometimes.
Things, so won't say it can't happen.
That's
but
true. Finishing off with a 10.2, that's very respectable there for Andrea Arsevich.
Yeah, so now we'll, of course, watch Sonia and see if she can stay in the final, which I think is a pretty good possibility.
Nice. We're seeing some really good scores here. Wu just shot a 10.8.
Yeah,
leading now on File Shifter, finishing off.
I think we could possibly see some flip-flopping up top as well.
I think you're right.
Or at least
she just waited down to the very last seconds.
Yes.
10.4 for File Shifter. That definitely keeps her in the standings, and we are going to have to say goodbye now to Andrea Arsevich. Yes, nicest girl ever.
Yes, we need to keep an eye on her. She's been an up-and-coming the last few years, I think, and we see her in many finals now, and she's a great shooter.
So we've got Yi still holding on to first. She's losing her lead just a little bit, like by tenths of a point after each shot here. Wu has now overtaken Maksimovic, and she's up by four-tenths of a point. This is going to be a really, really tough one. We've got Chang only 3/10 of a point behind File Shifter and two shots to go to find out who's going to end up in fifth place.
And I think anyone can be down there.
Yeah.
It's quite close. Not very many points separating them. One bad shot can make the difference.
Got some diehards here in the audience.
Yes.
You know?
Yes. It's always good to see. I think the audience needs to be a little more exciting.
I think so too. It's at 10.0 for File Shifter. So after shot number 13, the high scores. They are definitely making this exciting for us.
So yeah.
File Shifter is holding on to fourth place only by 2/10 of a point. Chung is right there behind her. We have Yi still in first place, only 6/10 of a point now in first place. Wu still on second, and still in second, not on second. That would be a different sport altogether. Maksimovic is in third place by 4/10 of a point. File Shifter is down 1.3/10 of a point. So it's a real fight right now for fifth place between File Shifter and Chang.
Yeah, and they're both quite a ways back from third.
Yes.
But we just saw Chang up there in the top two, so
that's right.
Obviously, things can change.
Yeah, it was kind of it's interesting to see how you all can do it. You go through a year with World Cups. Some years you all have the World Cup, World Championships, and you have the World Cup final, and the audience is always so stone silent. And then you go to the Olympic Games, and it's just mayhem.
Completely different.
I don't know how you do it. I really don't.
Yeah, I think, you know, especially at the Olympics, you have a lot of people that don't know about shooting
right.
at the Olympics. So mm-hmm. they just want to go and see an Olympic event.
And they
don't care what it is.
They're excited about it.
Yeah, and it's always great. It's exciting to have the audience a little more involved, I think. Some people might disagree.
10.3, that's going to be enough for File Shifter to stay in the game.
Yes. And she has some work to do to
she does.
Move up into the medals, but if anyone can do it, I think she's
the one to keep our eyes on without a doubt.
One that can, and I mean...
And finishing off now in fifth place, we have Chang Jing from the People's Republic of China. We're not too worried about having the People's Republic of China not be on the podium, at least one of them, with three of
yes.
them entering into the final. You know, we've only got 4/10 of a point now, separating first to second place between Yi and Wu. Maksimovic is in third by almost a point behind. File Shifter is down by 1.2/10 of a point. And this is where you're going to really see the talent come through. And
yeah, you know, now you're fighting for a medal. This is probably... These two shots are probably the hardest two shots.
Yeah.
Because it's for fourth and third. You know, I mean, once this one's over, you know you have a medal.
That's right. And you can calm down a little bit after that.
I mean, of course, everyone wants to win the gold medal. But, you know, fourth and third is always probably the hardest one to fight for.
10.8 there for Yi.
Yeah, she definitely wants to win this.
Yes, she does. Maksimovic, a 10.6. File Shifter 10.4.
And she has some work to do now. She needs some help from the ladies for Sonia not to get eliminated.
That's right. And that will be really too bad for all the people that have come here today. There's a lot of spectators
there
back today.
Yes,
it's standing room only, which is great to see.
Definitely.
You know, with that 10.8, Yi has now bounced back up the scoreboard. She's got a full point advantage over her teammate Wu. Maksimovic is a half a point behind her, and File Shifter 1.4/10 of a point, and in fourth place. Anything can happen, as we've seen. We have seen all year long that you
yes.
think you know who's going to be on the highest step of the podium, and all of a sudden, all hell breaks loose, and you say, wait a minute, what just happened here?
Yeah, anything, definitely anything can happen. I think with this elimination, it makes it a little more stressful as well.
Yes.
Maybe don't know yet, because I haven't tried it, but I'm assuming.
Well, your time's coming up, my dear. Tomorrow, in fact, you're yes. going to be on the hot seat.
We will see.
Nice. A 10.6 for
that
Yi.
That is definitely good shooting. And
nice. 10.7
for Maksimovic. Definitely hanging in there, fighting her way.
10.0 for Wu.
I think
that
we
could
will
change things around
see,
a little bit here.
Yeah, Maksimovic move up to second.
Yes.
But.
And a 10.7, nice way to finish off.
Finish well, but not enough.
No, it's not going to be enough for Sonia Fileshifter finishing off in fourth place.
10.7, but taking fourth place in the competition, representing Germany, Sonia Fileshifter.
So let's see if we can take a look. There she is, Sonia Fileshifter of Germany, finishing off in fourth place. And things are, you're absolutely right. We've got Maksimovic has now moved up, overtaking Wu by 0.2 of a point. Yi is in the lead by 1.4 of a point. It's going to come down to these last few shots to find out who's going to be going home with the bronze and the silver and the gold.
Yes,
I have a feeling
definitely.
That Yi can probably hold her own.
I think so. I would have to agree with
yeah.
that. And I think we'll see a fight here for second and third, definitely.
Yeah.
They're only 0.2 of a point apart, so we'll definitely have to see what happens here.
You know, Maksimovic. Oh, geez.
Wow.
A 10.9 for Yi.
She's another 10.9.
She is unbelievably consistent in her shooting, though.
Definitely.
She doesn't seem like she gets rattled. Nice. So 10.8 for Wu.
And
a 10.1 for Maksimovic. That's going to change things again around.
Yeah, Maksimovic took a shot quite late there. And
well, I'm sure that probably the applause from the crowd
yeah,
two
definitely.
Times probably set her off a little bit.
Definitely.
Look at that, almost 2 points between Yi and Wu. Yi is ahead by 1.7 of a point, and Maksimovic is holding on to third place by half a point. And I'm still, I wouldn't put money down on anybody as far as
no.
who's going home with the bronze.
Me neither.
Not that I ever was a real betting woman, but I certainly would not do it in the sport. No,
no
chance.
Not anymore, especially not with going to zero. Anyone in a world level can definitely go home with a medal.
Yeah. Yep.
We saw it yesterday with Rapid Fire.
That was amazing.
With Emil. And
yeah.
he was quite a ways back going into the final. And
he really was.
Ended up shooting a great final, so you can see anything can happen in these finals now.
And what a way to finish off, you know, shooting a perfect 5 out of 5
yes,
hits just to finish it off.
It was
awesome. Lovely.
Of course, we always like to see the American flag being raised.
Of course.
Hearing our national anthem.
10.3 for Yi. That still is going to keep her right up there. Woo, 10.0. Now, things could change around here.
Maksimovic can definitely come up, and
oh,
she has.
10.7. Very
yes.
nice shooting.
It's very good recovery, and
unbelievable.
She will fight. Have a hard fight for gold.
Yes, she will definitely have a hard fight for gold, but gosh, she bounced right up there and ended up right now for the moment in second place. But our bronze medalist here, Wu Liuxi from the People's Republic of China. We know that we're going to have two women from the People's Republic of China on the podium today. We just didn't know where they were going to fall into place. I've got my sights pretty much on Yi for the gold.
Yes, if I was a betting woman, I would probably bet. But, you know, and we have seen crazier things happen.
This
so,
is true.
It is really great to see Maksimovic shooting so well, and she's hanging in there. She's been bouncing back between, you know, fourth and second
exactly
here, this whole final. So,
and she's also someone we got to keep our eyes on because she is really up and coming.
Yeah, definitely. In both guns as well.
Mm-hmm. Nice, a 10.6.
He is definitely trying to secure that gold medal.
Yeah. It's a very respectable shot there for Maksimovic.
There's almost 2 points difference, so we will have to see a very poor shot.
And
from
I don't
Yi.
See that happening with Yi.
Yes.
She is so consistent in her shooting. but it's going to come right down to this last shot to find out who's going to be on the highest step of the podium. Then we're going to be moving that on over to the men's event later on this afternoon, I believe at noon today.
Yes.
And Jamie's going to be right here sitting next to me again, which will be a pleasure once again.
So we'll have to see Yi shoot in the eights.
Yeah.
Here to... Yeah.
To
have a change.
And I don't know if I've ever seen her shoot in the eights, to be honest with you.
I don't know that you should have said that, Hillary.
Oops, don't. Dear Lord. I gotta watch out what I say with people around here, you know.
No, I don't think we have either, but... And
9.8,
but it will be good enough.
That's fine.
Yep. It's great shooting. Regardless, her average is over 105, and it's very good shooting.
Nice. So 10.6 to finish off there. We brought the difference down to 1.1 tenths of a point. But there is our gold medalist, Yi Siling from the People's Republic of China, just doing a banner job today, as always. She set a new world record during qualifications, and now is going home with the gold. There she is, gold medalist Yi Siling. She always, during interviews, always has something sweet to say to her parents.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And there is our silver medalist, Ivana Maksimovic from Serbia. Fantastic shooting, really, really great. This, wondering if that's her parents. Here, maybe.
Yeah, it's definitely coming up and a young shooter to keep your eye on.
Absolutely. Well, Jamie, thank you so much for joining us today. We're going to grab you later on and sit you right back down again.
Yes.
And for the men's event.
Perfect.
And hopefully we'll have a great turnout like we did for the women's.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Thomas Lasevich, Chairman of the Jury of Appeal. He is accompanied by Mr. Paul Gunn, Member of the Classification Jury. Your bronze medalist, representing the People's Republic of China, Wu Liuxi. Your silver medalist, representing Serbia, Ivana Maksimovic. And your gold medalist, representing the People's Republic of China, Yi Siling. ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.